Part 2 of this lecture on trends and scenarios will discuss scenario analysis. Scenario building can be defined as a technique that provides a logical order of events that describes how, starting from the current situation, the future can develop step by step. But why should we consider scenarios? The answer to that question is that scenarios help decision makers, both in the public and private sectors, in making choices. It helps them to identify what the possible impact of their decisions may be in terms of investments, policy choices, long-term targets, and so on. These decisions namely have their impact over many years, often decades. Governments use scenario as a tool for preparing energy or environmental policy, for example. Companies use scenarios to estimate the market opportunities of their products, to assess risks, or to attain an optimum planning of their investments. Finally, non-governmental organizations, such as environmental protection organizations, develop scenarios to draw attention to alternative policy options, for example. Let's take a look at some energy scenarios now. First, we shall look at the scenarios which the International Energy Agency prepared for us in the World Energy Outlook. The World Energy Outlook is probably the most cited scenario work. It is published annually. The International Energy Agency works with three different scenarios. In the first scenario, called the current policy scenario, it is assumed that no new policy measures are implemented. As you see, energy use increases strongly. In the new policy scenario, also policies that are in the pipeline are assumed to be implemented. This is the central scenario in the World Energy Outlook. Current policies and even proposed policies are far from sufficient to stay below 2 degrees C in climate change-related temperature increase. Therefore, a third scenario is added. The 450 scenario is in line with 2 degrees C. In this scenario, the growth of energy demand is strongly moderated. Let's look what happens to renewable energy. In the current policy scenario, we see that the share of renewables sticks at 14% of the total primary energy supply all the way to 2040. In the new policy scenario, we notice a decent increase in the share of renewables to 19%. But in the 450 scenario, we notice the highest increase to 30%. For all three scenarios, there is still a significant role for fossil fuels in 2040. Within energy scenarios, a key question may be, is a fully sustainable energy system possible, for example, by 2050? Companies like the Dutch energy consultancy firm Ecofys do consider this plausible. In this image, you see how our energy system may develop towards 2050, according to the Ecofys scenario. It looks fully sustainable, but there is still some use of fossil fuels. However, with the utilization of carbon capture and sequestration technology, they can potentially be carbon neutral. The thing with scenarios is that they carry a lot of uncertainty. Scenarios try to describe a possible future, a future which is inevitably uncertain. We cannot determine how the factors supporting the scenario will turn out in the future. However, there are some factors which are less uncertain than others. One of them is an increasing electrification of the world. Electricity will become a much more important energy carrier due to the implementation of heat pumps, electric mobility, etc., and the fact that many renewable technologies in the field of the modern renewables are particularly suitable for electricity generation. Over all three scenarios from the International Energy Agency, the generation of power from renewable sources is expected to increase with between 125 and 250% in 2040 relative to 2014. On the other hand, uncertainty exists in our future energy demand, dependent on, for instance, economic and population growth, but also on the developments in energy efficiency. In some scenarios, global energy demand grows strongly. In others, it even decreases. In addition, also our future energy supply is uncertain. There is especially uncertainty in the field of the actual role of unconventional energy sources and renewable energy technology. The role of the latter be as modest as today, but could also be close to 100% in this century. All with all, there is huge uncertainty about our energy future. But scenarios help us to set out a vision, a strategy for the future. Thank you.